Hello guys. Ever since I was a child, I was a crybaby. I cried when I could not watch my favorite show. I cried when I would lose the game of Monopoly. I cried when I would get the slightest scar possible from tripping on a rock. I cried on every single minor inconvenience I could possibly think of. Crying was like my only way of expressing my negative emotions out loud to other people. But crying isn't really the best way to do that. Crying makes other people sad and down, and nobody wants to be with people who are sad all the time, right? So I didn't fit in. Other people knew that I would cry if they would arouse my deeper emotions. As I grew up, the people's discomfort with my sensitivity only became more apparent each day. And the isolation I felt from that really spiked up. I was done with all the arrows and sighs of other people. I wanted change. That's why I decided to mask my overwhelming emotions and my sensitive personality with one action, a smile. As I hid behind my smile more, the more my wishes came true. I began getting surrounded by many friends who were actually willing to hang out with me. I became being as the nice guy at school, you know, the one that compliments other people, cracks a joke in class to make them laugh, and listened to them when they were in need. They said I had a good personality. They said I was outgoing and easy to talk to. But as time went on, I wanted more. I started out small, like carrying other people's backpacks or, you know, giving them a candy. But surely I wanted more approval. My need for approval grew much more than that, and my priorities and boundaries became distorted. 20 rice balls in my lunchbox meant that my friends would get some, always, meaning that there would only be one or two rice balls left for me at that lunch. Hanging out with my friends became my number one priority, meaning that my family time and study time would get pushed back or even canceled. But I still said to myself, this isn't enough. My obsession with approval got so much that it turned more like an addiction. You know, I couldn't stop doing it despite the obvious harmful consequences it brought. But the effects of this became clear as this went on. I was getting apprehensive, and the ruminations and voices in my head and the echo chamber of all the different weird looks and comments I've gotten haunted me throughout the day. My thoughts were solely directed into analyzing what other people might think about me that I didn't really have time for myself. Friendly looks became cold, rigid stares, and I began to burn out. I knew that I was a burden to other people, and my mind slowly turned into thinking that it was a true fact. A true fact that can never be changed. Nobody likes me. Why am I still even here? I specifically remember when I got to my house, tired and exhausted, and I quickly went inside my room and slammed the door. I just had a fight with my parents. I turned the light off and I fell down to the floor. Life just seemed really monotonous and lifeless. The discord of screams and wails came out of me. And I was really just sad and down. And the walls, the clocks, the windows, it started to distort and twist, and my thoughts were zooming all over the place, and my head was swarming, like, really badly. And with all the chaos happening, I took a glimpse at the mirror and saw a totally different person. A person that was hurt, ill, destroyed, and hopeless. Hey, this is not me. This isn't the person who I wanted to be. I figured that this was a warning sign, a warning sign that alerted me to change as a person somehow. And I knew that if I kept going that way, then I would not know what would happen. It would be bad. But what would I do to change myself? To find out, I decided to feel my real, authentic emotions inside of me. I decided to roll out whatever emotion that was and just, you know, deal with it. Fear, embarrassment, jealousy, sadness, but also happiness and joyness and proudness. I processed them one by one. By feeling my authentic emotions, I have found my own beliefs and interests, and I decided that I would do what I wanted to do instead of what other people wanted me to do. I have found a hobby in singing, which I'll get to share with you today. And lastly, I have learned how to love myself again. I have set my boundaries, and I've learned to say no sometimes because it's okay to be myself and to feel my emotions. I still have times where I need other people to like me. I still think about the littlest arguments in the past and the littlest mistakes. But by embracing my sensitivity and who I really am, maybe it doesn't matter what other people might think about me, as long as I'm satisfied with myself. Today, I'm singing to you guys about a song that tells you that it's okay to be yourself. It's okay to not be somebody else in order for the other person to like you. Here is The Scientist by Coldplay. Enjoy. Check, check, check. To the star, I was just guessing at numbers and figures, pulling the puzzles apart. Questions of science, science of progress, tomorrow.
speak as loud as my heart. Tell me you love me. Come back and haunt me. When I rush to the start. I'm going back to the start.